It's sweet, sweet, the wind's in my hair. Nothing can make me feel down, down, down. Beep, beep, the neighbor say hi. I'm gonna be-
Hey loves, welcome back to my channel. My name is Adanna, and if it's your first time stopping by, hello who? Hello boo. So today's video, I'm going to be taking all through this super easy spring. It's giving spring, it's giving summer, it's giving everything, it's giving no pressure. I will take you all through this entire springy afro twist hairstyle. If you don't even feel comfortable gripping the roots of your braids or your twist, don't worry. In this video, I'm going to show you all a couple methods that you could use to achieve this hairstyle without even having to grip the roots of this twist, and you would not even need to use any rubbers at all. Yo, first things first, the hair extension that we're using to achieve this hairstyle is a twisted up springy afro kinky twist from Outree, and thanks to Outree for partnering up with us in this video. The extension that we're using today is in 24 inches and it's in color 1B. The texture is just so beautiful, it's so soft, and it blends perfectly well with our type 4 natural hair. The extension comes pre-fluffed and pre-stretched, so you don't even have to do anything. It's just prepared for you already straight out of the box. So for this twist that we're going to be doing right now, all we're going to need to do is to grab one strand of this extension, split that into two equal halves, and then each of those halves I went ahead to cut that into two. So this little quarter right here is what we're going to use for each strand of twist, and this is the exact same size of hair that I use for my entire head of hair. So starting off with the very first method, I'll be showing you all two different methods that you could use to achieve this twist as previously mentioned. For this first method, I'm just going to go ahead right now to use my Shine and Jam gel just to kind of like, you know, slick down the hair that I parted out, and then I went ahead to use my edge brush to just brush this, you know, give it a little swoop. When it comes to braiding, you all know how much I love the Shine and Jam gel. It just always gives a very nice, flexible and juicy hold for your natural hair in terms of braiding. So for this first method right now, I'm going to go ahead to grab this extension and then grab my natural hair and make this into a three-stranded braid. So like as if you're going to do your regular box braids, okay? And then I just go ahead to keep on braiding this up until about 3 to 4 steps of braids, after which I just went ahead right now to split my natural hair. Right there in the middle, I went ahead to split my natural hair into two equal halves, so that each strand of my natural hair can go to each side of this extension. And then once we split that right there, we're just going to go ahead to continue twisting. Yo, ignore my parting right here. My parting at the back just never likes to follow instructions. And I really wanted to show you guys how I achieved the back as well, because I know y'all always ask me, and then like, can you please show the back? So manage it please, thank you. Yo, to be honest, you all know the traditional way to twist hair where they put the extension at the root and start twisting from the root. Y'all, I struggle with that method so much. Every time I try it, it's just So this is a method that I feel always works perfectly for me, and guess what, this method is very fast. So I'm just going to go ahead to repeat this particular method again, just to make sure that we're carrying everyone along prior to showing those of us that don't feel comfortable gripping the roots of our braids or even doing this method at all. I'll be showing you all a different method right after this one. So I'm going to go ahead to use my Shine and Jam gel, and I just use this to hold my natural hair together. Grabbed one strand of this extension, of this kinky twist, or kinky extension, as if kinky twist, of this kinky extension, split that right there into two equal halves, and then grab each half of that, separate it, make sure it's all fluffed out, because the more fluffed out it is, the more it actually blends with your natural hair very seamlessly. And then I just went ahead to cut that in the middle into two. Grabbing this quarter strand of hair, we're just going to go ahead to attach this to our natural hair, with our natural hair being in the middle and being the third strand of hair. We're going to use this to make a three-stranded braid. Just like you're doing your regular box braids, you cross over just like so. I feel like this part of crossing over and crisscrossing, I have to let you guys just watch it and understand what I'm trying to explain. I find this particular method to be very quick, and I do not even have to use any rubbers at all because your natural hair is well gripped from the roots, so you don't even need to use any elastic band if you don't want to. And then once we get to about 3 to 4 steps of this braid, we're just going to go ahead to split our natural hair into 2 equal halves across each side of this extension, and then we're going to go ahead to start twisting from there. For this twisting, you want to make sure that you're twisting this extension all the way to the very end, because personally I did not soak this hair in hot water. I didn't want the ends to be silky or straight. I wanted everything to look very natural. I wanted it to look curly. I wanted it to look kinky. I just wanted it to look very, you know. Yo, this hairstyle has been one of my favorite hairstyles. It's so lightweight, especially now that it's starting to get hot. This is just the perfect hairstyle if you're looking for something very easy and ready to go any time of the day. Okay, so for this next method, we're going to grab our natural hair that's parted out right here, apply some Shine and Jam gel, and then we're going to go ahead to split our natural hair into 3 strands. And then grabbing these 3 strands of our natural hair, we're going to go ahead to put this into a 3-stranded braid. So just like you're doing your regular box braids, we're just braiding our natural hair right now. And once you feel that the root of your natural hair is properly secure, that's how you know that, you know, we're on the right path to the next step. On the other hand, you don't want the root of your natural hair to be too tight, because we're going to be doing crochet right here, and you want to be able to have this extension pass through the root of your hair easily. So passing through this crochet hook, we're going to grab our kinky hair extension, grabbing it from the end, and then we're just going to put this onto the crochet hook, lock the crochet hook, and then just slowly pass this through. And yo, shout out to the beautiful J Marie for inspiring this particular method. Yo, in fact, shout out to her for inspiring this hairstyle, because she's a babe. This hairstyle came through. I saw her rocking this hairstyle sometime last year, and right away, y'all, I fell in love with it. I was like, you know what? I need to try this. It looked so good, so flawless. And here we are today, rocking some springy Afro twists. Hallelujah, somebody. And yo, once we are done passing this extension through our natural hair, we're just going to go ahead right now to split our natural hair into 2 equal halves, so across the 2 sides of this extension, and then right away, so easily, we're going to go ahead to start twisting. This method is perfect for those of us that don't want to grip the roots of our braids, or don't even feel comfortable gripping the roots of our braids. This method is for you. The natural hair plait that we did at the beginning, at the root of our hair, just holds and secures this extension so firmly, like it's very secure. And then right now, I'm just going to go ahead to repeat this particular method again, just to make sure that we're carrying everyone along as always. For this entire hair of head, I use only 1 pack of hair, y'all. 1 pack. And guess what? I did not even finish the entire 1 pack, because the entire 1 pack of hair comes with 3 bundles, and from these 3 bundles, I only ended up using 2 bundles. So from that entire 3 bundle of hair, we only used 2 bundles. So that is how convenient and affordable this hairstyle is. Okay, we're going to go back right now to explaining this particular method again, just so we can make sure that, you know, everyone is following. So this is our natural hair that we just braided right now into a 3-stranded braid. We did about 3 to 4 steps of this braid. Just make sure that the root of your hair is properly secure but not too tight. And then we're going to pass our crochet hook through the root of our natural hair and then grab this extension. You can easily split your natural hair into 2 equal sides, 1 on each strand of this kinky extension if your hair is quite thick. However, if your natural hair is quite thin, just like the front of my natural hair, you do not even need to split your natural hair across the 2 sides of this extension. You could just put your natural hair onto 1 side of the extension and then keep on twisting. It's still going to be the same thing, the same method, everything is still going to look flawless. But like I said, if your natural hair is quite thick, for this particular method, you would need to split your natural hair across the 2 sides of this extension, just so the thickness of the extension on both sides of your hair would be equal and everything would look flawless. Finally, it's time for the very last braid. For this last braid, we're just going to go ahead to use the other method, which is the one that requires you to grip the roots of your braids. I love that method. I feel like it's just faster. I think that's the main reason why I actually prefer this particular method, because regardless, I found that both methods, either of them, still holds the roots of your natural hair very securely. That's really an English word, but you get the point. They both hold your natural hair very well. A quick tip I wanted to share with you guys is for this particular twist, this Afro kinky twist, when twisting the body of this hair, you want to make sure that you're not twisting it too tight. So you want to make sure that while you're smoothing and making sure that your natural hair is all staying in place, as you're twisting, don't twist it too tight, kind of twist it a little loosely. I found that at the very beginning, at the back of my hair, when I was twisting it too tight, it didn't come out looking fluffy and natural looking. It was kind of looking a little too silky. And I didn't really know what was going on, because this is my first time ever trying this particular hairstyle. So I was like, why is this thing looking too silky? I don't want it to look like this. But if you rewind it to the very first twisted hair, the very first twist that we did at the back, you will notice that the fluffiness is not as fluffy as this was in front, because I realized I was holding the extension too tight. Like I was dragging it too much. So try not to do it too tight when twisting, just like this. Just a little pressure as you're twisting would perfectly work. And then while I was twisting, I just went ahead to touch up with some Shine and Jam gel while making sure that my natural hair keeps staying secure along this entire twist. So like I said, I'm not going to dip this hair in hot water, so I made sure that I twisted it all the way to the very end and even swirled the end of this twist, just so it's extra secure and to give it that natural look. Right now, we're just going to go ahead to trim all the ends of this hair that we did not trim during the entire twisting process. I'm just trimming everything. You want to make sure that you're trimming in like a shabby, like, I don't know how to explain it. You know that kind of, don't just cut, because you don't want the ends to look too blunt, so you just kind of give it that I don't know what I'm saying, but that rough cut, exactly, just so it looks natural. And then I'm just going to oil my scalp right now using the kaleidoscope hair oil, and then to finally secure all the flyaways on this hair and everything, just so everything is sitting, I'm using my relaxed hair mousse and I just apply this all over. And here is the final look of this hair, y'all. I ended up with 66 strands of twist. I know someone is going to ask, so I just helped you to count. Okay, I ended up with 66 strands of braids, and I left this on overnight because I finished this hair at about 4 a.m. in the morning. Literally, this hair took me 5 hours. Okay, this hair took me 5 hours. So this is the following morning, and I'm going to go ahead to use my Style Factor Edge Booster pomade as well as the Style Factor Edge Booster gel to slick down my edges. Like I always say, the Style Factor Edge Booster pomade turns white on my edges, so I always have to go over top of that using the gel. And then right now I'm going to go ahead to secure this and lay this down using my head wrap. And hello hello. And then you all know what's next. We have to accessorize this hair. We're just going to add only one accessory because I felt like this hairstyle did not even need anything too much. So just one gold jewelry right there on this hair. And this is it for this look. A girl is serving peppermint candy. Like scrumptious, delicious something. Excuse you. Yo, I love this hairstyle. It's so lightweight. It's just so perfect. I had to give you guys at least one hairstyle just to spice it up a little bit. Kind of like a side ponytail with some fringe. And this is basically for this entire look, y'all. I hope y'all enjoyed this video. And I also hope y'all found it helpful. Let me know down below in the comment section which of the two methods we used in this video works best for you. Don't forget to thumbs up this video, subscribe, share, and I will see you all in my next one. Have a wonderful rest of your day. Bye.
It's your happy day. It's your wedding day. Make we celebrate. Make we celebrate. To make you dance. Yeah.